Tourism has always been a major part of Florida's legacy, and St. Lucie County is very much part of that tradition. But have you explored all that St. Lucie County has to offer? From professional sporting events to pristine waters and secluded environmental preserves, from marine education centers and museums to diverse cultural festivals, St. Lucie County has something for everyone. So join us as we vacation in our own backyard and send you postcards from home.
Welcome to Postcards from Home, a show that highlights St. Lucie County's natural and cultural treasures. I'm your host, Erick Gill, and each month we take a look at some of St. Lucie County's best-known parks, museums, and nature preserves, as well as highlighting some of its best-kept secrets. Today, we'll be exploring Fort Pierce's largest indoor special events facility, the Havert L. Fenn Center. With more than 32,000 square feet of rentable space, the Fenn Center can host a variety of events, from basketball and karate tournaments to small corporate meetings to large exhibition and retail shows. Whether you need a place to host an upscale banquet or a 3,000-person community event, the staff at the Fenn Center can set up the facility to meet your needs. In addition to the large gymnasium and six breakout multi-purpose rooms, the Fenn Center houses a fully equipped kitchen, a concession stand, locker rooms equipped with ADA-accessible showers, and all your audio and video needs. So let's go meet Charlotte Byerly, Tourism and Venues Manager for St. Lucie County, who tell us more about this unique rental facility. Well, Charlotte, thanks for taking the time today to meet me here inside the Fenn Center. First, let's start with the background and the name. Who is Havert L. Fenn?
Well, he is a local resident, I think affectionately known as Coach. I haven't been able to meet him yet, unfortunately, but Mr. Fenn, Coach Fenn is what people call him, was a huge contributor to education and athletics in St. Lucie County. He was also a city commissioner, a Fort Pierce city commissioner, as well as a St. Lucie County commissioner. And he was very instrumental in the county's parks and rec facilities, as well as what I just learned is bringing the New York Mets to St. Lucie County. Okay. So a very prominent figure, an important figure in our history of sports here in the county.
Absolutely. And speaking of sports, he's actually a member of the Sports Hall of Fame, which is located here inside the Fenn Center, upstairs in the balcony area there?
Yes. To date, we have 61 members in our Hall of Fame. All of them range from different sports backgrounds, whether a coach or an athlete or an administrator. So we have them all very proudly displayed upstairs. They each have a photo and a little bio to explain what their accomplishments were. So yeah, it's a nice little feature we have here at the center.
And it used to be inside the old Civic Center, which was just down the street here on Virginia, at the corner of Virginia and 25th Street. And that facility was torn down in 2004 after the hurricanes, 10 years ago. It's hard to believe that that anniversary is coming
up. I know.
But that facility served a lot of functions, from graduations to home shows, craft shows, but it was also, first and foremost, a special needs shelter, which that was really the impetus for building this facility.
Yes, you are correct. First and foremost, the Fenn Center is a special needs shelter. So in the case, if we are activated in an emergency, this would be the county special needs shelter. It was built right now. It can accommodate 648 special needs patients. So it's a very very well-built facility.
Category 5.
It can withstand a Category 5 hurricane. It's completely self-sustaining. It has backup generators. It has bathrooms, shower facilities, a full commercial kitchen, and even laundry facilities. So it's very well equipped.
In mentioning the special needs shelter, this isn't going to be a shelter where people can just come up in the event that we've issued evacuations. You have to pre-register for that, and residents can do that on the St. Lucie County website, our public safety website. You can pre-register for those special
needs. Yes, and the health department really encourages you to pre-register, because it's really going to help the whole flow of traffic in the event that there is an emergency. So if you're already registered, you come in directly and don't have to go through all the paperwork.
Sure. And I know we don't want to harp too much on the safety aspects of the facility, but we've done some special needs drills here with the health department. Some of your breakout rooms, they can be used for smaller conference rooms and triage as patients come in. And
yes.
One of the unique things is, and folks probably can't see it behind us, but in the ceiling there's actually electrical outlets that'll come down in the event that we lose power. Hopefully the generators will kick in, but and then dialysis machines can continue to run.
That is correct. And it serves two needs. First and foremost, it serves the special needs. But if we host, or we have hosted in the past, an expo where we have a bunch of trade show booths set up, and those booths need electricity. We have electric throughout the entire exhibition hall or gymnasium, so it's kind of a double positive for us.
Now, when this opened up around 2008, 2009, I think the county saw it as a catch-all facility. There was jazzercise classes, and then there were basketball league, mm-hmm. open rec, but also they were trying to book events and venues.
Yes.
But this board has kind of changed that direction.
Yes. Like you said, when it first opened, it was doing both. It was running the recurring programs and also doing special events. And it was just becoming a large operation to run, and scheduling was becoming very difficult to manage. So, we had the big economic downturn. The board needed to made some decisions, and it was decided to put the Fenn Center program specifically for special events. So we phased out the programming. They went to smaller facilities, city-owned facilities, and some privately owned facilities, some church facilities can accommodate those recurring programs, so they still exist, but we are focusing primarily on special events. So it becomes a little bit more manageable for us. We do have a limited staff, but it's going well.
Sure. Now, what, since that change has happened, you've had everything from wrestling events here, there's been athletic karate tournaments.
Yes. A wide variety of events, and primarily we want to bring events in that will also bring an economic impact to the area. So we are focusing on attracting sports events, whether it's cheerleading, karate tournaments. We're really trying to get some gymnastics meets, things like that. And then we also focus on regional and state meetings, government or corporate meetings, training seminars. We've hosted quite a large number of training seminars, even with just some regional companies. So, it varies very much, but I would be remiss to say if we also host community events. So it's not just only the outside events are welcome in this facility. Community events are hosted here, community fundraisers, corporate company banquets. We're hosting, a couple of corporate Christmas parties of local companies coming up in the season. So
the political fundraisers have been had here. There's a school, back to school things being set up behind us.
Yeah, there's definitely community job fairs. There's definitely community oriented events as well. But, our job is to operate those events, but to more so attract those outside events to bring visitors into the area. And that's why the board opted to move the Fenn Center under tourism, because it all kind of made sense that way.
Sure. And it's about 32,000 square feet of rentable space?
That's correct. The gymnasium behind us and all of the multi-purpose room total about 32,000 square feet. And the whole facility is about 62,000 square feet.
Sure. So that's a lot of building to maintain.
But yes.
And it's unique because the small breakout rooms, you can arrange it a lot of different ways. You can have one room, two rooms, three rooms.
We have retractable walls in rooms 2 through 6.
Sure.
So if you want to connect all of those rooms, you can. If you just want to connect 2 or 3. So yeah, there's a lot of versatility.
We'll see those a little later. But even the gym behind us is unique because there's curtains that can drop and you can divide that. There's bleachers that come out. You can have 3 basketball games going on at one time, or volleyball games.
Exactly.
Or you can leave it like this and have a large convention. Mm-hmm.
If you have 100 people that you necessarily don't want to put in the multi-purpose room, you want the large, tall ceiling gymnasium, you can put down one of the curtains so it feels a little bit more intimate and you have a lot of open air space.
Sure.
There's a lot of versatility.
One of the things we didn't touch on too is when this facility was built, most of the funding for it actually wasn't tax dollars. It came from state and federal grants as well as insurance money.
Yes, as a result of the hurricanes, the county did receive a lot of insurance money, and it was also funded by the federal and state governments to the tune of about 90% of the total cost of the project, which I believe was about $13 million.
Right. And it was also designed and constructed using recyclable materials and energy efficiencies.
Yes, a lot of green technologies were used in the construction of the facility. We have, I think, almost all of our interior drywall was used using recycled paper. We have 75% of the steel was recycled, 50% of the aluminum used was recycled. So
and there's passive lighting and as much as we can.
As much as we can.
There's these cloudy, rainy days like today, there's not much light.
Right, no, there was a lot of green technologies used, so we're very proud of that.
Yeah. Now, how far in advance are you all booking and how can people, how are you guys getting the word out there?
We are, you know, it's been 2 years, almost 2 years since we've been operating under this sort of new focus. And we have learned that we've kind of identified some niches. So one of our main markets is faith-based events. We've hosted a lot of church or faith-based events, and we found that we can grow this. So we are actively and aggressively pursuing on building on that. And sports is also just sort of an obvious fit for us.
Sure.
So we work very closely with the Treasure Coast Sports Commission to program this facility for sporting events.
Yeah. And on the sports side, you're right here as part of the Longwood or John B. Parks complex. Mm-hmm. So you've got the football field, the baseball field, there's a concrete skate park. So there's a lot of additional amenities right here on the property.
Exactly. And we also have, compared to other similar facilities in the area, we have over 1,000 hotel rooms within 3 miles. So that is a huge advantage to people looking at this facility from out of the area.
Let's talk a little bit too about what's available inside here to rent. I mean, it's not just a big box. You probably have seating and tables.
We
and
do.
You have technology available. There's screens that come down.
Correct. We have tables and chairs are included with your rental, as well as the basic setup for it. Our staff will set that up for you in the arrangement that you choose. So that is included. We do have AV capabilities. We have projectors. We have smart boards.
Free Wi-Fi.
Free Wi-Fi for anyone that enters into the facility. And in the gymnasium here, if you do have a large seminar, we have 10 by 7 foot screens that come down and projectors, so you could do a large scale presentation or seminar. And then again, the smart boards in the multi-purpose rooms, and you know, linens if you need if it's more
ADA
of an upscale
showers if you for the athletics locker rooms.
There's a lot here to offer, so
sure.
There is an additional charge for some of those extras, but tables and chairs are included.
So if I'm having a conference for the weekend, and is there concessions available, do you provide that, or do I bring my own cake, or how's that work?
We have in-house an exclusive in-house caterer and concessionaire. So if you're having a sporting event and you want to offer concessions to your attendees, we can provide that for you. And then if you are having a pride event or a banquet, there is a catering service available, and our caterer is and concessionaire is on contract with the county. It's DiMicelli's Catering. They can do a variety of food for a private event, ranging from an upscale sit-down dinner to, you know, a casual buffet or lunch boxes for a corporate meeting, and of course your general concession foods.
What I think was really interesting, about a year ago you hosted an open house here to showcase the different rooms and how they can look.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, it really opened up to the average resident that may want to have, like you said, an engagement party or a wedding reception or Sweet 16 or a 40th anniversary, you know, some of those rooms. Now, they were local designers that worked with you on setting that up?
Yes, we really wanted to showcase to local businesses and even local residents what this facility was really capable of doing. So we partnered with local party planners, local, you know, event equipment companies to choose one of these rooms during that open house and basically transform it in any way that they were capable of doing. So we had a bunch of different setups, and we did the gym in a trade show, you know, format, as well as a banquet format, and we had a very formal, you know, wedding reception set up in one of the rooms.
Sure.
And so it was.
So if I wanted to have a party and have a bubble machine, you may not have that on site, but you can work with, you guys have a list of vendors that can work with us.
We have contacts.
And cater
for sure.
to that specific theme party.
Absolutely.
Great. Now, what about future plans here at the Fenn Center?
We've done some great improvements already. We've added more electrical up in the gym ceiling, and you know, with our focus on faith-based events, we are looking at some improvements on the acoustics in the gymnasium. Just there's a lot of the faith-based events do music and singing. Sure. So
and it was built as a gym, not a
yeah, it's a gymnasium, cathedral. So the acoustics aren't exactly perfect for that. And you know, we just got the whole facility painted, which it needed. You know, it had been 6 years; it was starting to fade, so that's been an improvement. But we're also looking at some LED lighting just to save some funds on our utilities. That's an area we're looking into. And a great project was something that I love to do is in order to further showcase all that there is in the county and how beautiful our county is, we're getting some large format photography printed and putting up on some of our really big walls, bare walls that we have here in the facility.
Any of my shots? Or?
Yeah, there's a couple that you took.
Don't lie to me.
I swear.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm impressed. speaking of also improvements, you've added a new LED sign. You mentioned LED lighting.
Yes.
That's fairly new. And then
yes, and we added that 2 years ago. It is great because it allows us to further promote events that are going on here to motorists driving by. So
sure.
It's an added bonus to the renter. It's free 2 weeks prior. They get their message, their event up there at no additional charge. So it's definitely an incentive. And it's also important for public safety. If there is an emergency, we can post that message on that sure. board so people can see it.
And speaking of future events, if folks want to find out what's going on here at the Fenn Center, I know Matt's on the website updating those events.
Yes. The fenncenter.com is our website, and if you have any inquiries on renting the facility, you can call 462-1521 and our staff can give you a quote over the phone or you can schedule a tour.
Great. Yeah. Well, Charlotte, I know you've got things to do, probably ad plans to put together, marketing budgets, so if we have a few minutes, I'm going to take a tour with Matt and he can show me some of the setups of these rooms.
Yeah, definitely. We got it all set up for you.
Great. Thanks a lot.
Good to see you.
Don't go anywhere. Take a quick break. When we come back, we're going to take a tour here at the Havert Fenn Center.